To find the Shattered Throne, you need to get to Dreaming City, and on top of the map, you can find the launch icon. Alright guys, there's one thing I want to mention before starting the video, that there are multiple collectible objects throughout the Shattered Throne, like eggs, bones and secret chests. If you want to collect them, follow the link in the description below. Also, there are multiple encounters in the Shattered Throne. If you want to know any specific encounter, the timestamp is in the description below. The Shattered Throne dungeon can be done solo, but I would suggest finding two more people and do it with them. It would be much easier. Well, the starting area is pretty easy. You just have to go forward until you find a certain point where the enemies will spawn. Here you have to kill all the enemies. After killing the enemies, a symbol will spawn in front of you in the mid section of this area. It will be glowing. This symbol can change from time to time, and there will be another symbol in the wall from the inside area. The symbol on the wall will not change, but this symbol where you need to go, it can change each time you play this encounter. Now let's take a look at the symbol inside on the wall. Here you can see the symbol on the wall is kind of looking like a bird is falling down. So what you have to do here is, there will be a symbol on the wall, that specific symbol will not change. Like here we have a bird is falling down, that is your current location, that means you are at the symbol where the bird is falling down. This symbol will be fixed always, this will not change. So there will be another symbol that will be glowing, and that symbol can change always. So you have to be specific each time you play this encounter, and you have to remember all the locations of the symbols, so that each time you see a new symbol pop up, you have to go to that particular location, kill the adds. After you kill the adds, there will be a new symbol, and you have to identify the symbol where it is, and you have to go to that particular location. Let me demonstrate it here. After killing the adds here, we got this particular symbol which is glowing. So this is where we need to go. This symbol can change always, the glowing symbol can change always. But there is another symbol inside, this one, which is our current location. To complete this encounter easily, I have made a map. Here you can see there are 7 symbol totals in the map. There is a symbol in the bottom mid, which is our current location, highlighted with the yellow color. That symbol you can see on the wall inside, where you are starting the encounter. And the symbol we got, which was glowing after killing the adds, is on the bottom right side. You can see it is highlighted with the blue color. What you have to do is, the symbol that is fixed on the wall, from there you have to go to that particular symbol area where the symbol is glowing. So here in the bottom mid section, that is our current location, and we got the symbol glowing on the right hand side, bottom right. So we have to go from the mid section to the right side. Here you can see, this is the symbol we saw earlier that was glowing, and now that symbol is fixed on the wall. That means we have come to the right location, and there will be adds spawning here. After killing these adds, there will be another symbol spawning here that will be glowing. So now the symbol is on the wall, that will be our current location, and the symbol that will be glowing, that is where we need to go. Here you can see, after killing all the adds, we got another symbol which is glowing. That is the place where you need to go. And our current location is the previous symbol that we got. So here you can see in the map that our current location is highlighted with the yellow color, and the symbol that was glowing is highlighted with the blue color. So the symbol that is glowing, that is the place where you need to go from our current location. And the path I am taking is highlighted with the red color. There are multiple paths you can take to go from one symbol to another. So it might differ from time to time each time you play this encounter. Now let's go to the next symbol. Here you can see this is the symbol that was glowing previously, and here you have to kill all the ads, and after that another symbol will pop up and you have to go to that place. Here you can see another glowing symbol has appeared, and now this is where you need to go. Here you can see on the map the path I am taking to go from the current location to the new location. Here you can see another glowing symbol has appeared. This is where you need to go now. This is the path I am taking to go from my current location to the new symbol. This time we got an infinite snake looking symbol. This is where you need to go now. Remember, each time you do this encounter, the glowing symbols will change. So you have to find the glowing symbol location on the map, then go there from your current location. This is the path I am taking. You can see the new symbol here and the path I am taking. This is the final symbol you need to get. Once you have completed all 6 other symbols, then this will be the last symbol that will spawn, and this is actually the area where you started this encounter, so you have to go back there. And this is the path I am taking. After you complete the first encounter, the center area will open and you have to jump inside it. After you reach the ground floor, there will be a door. Go through that door. In this area, there will be a lot of ads and sniper. You can skip these ads if you want, but if you are doing it for the first time, I would suggest kill the ads patiently. And there will be a lot of snipers, so use something ranged like scout rifle or sniper rifles. You can jump here and go to the top, otherwise there is a staircase on the right side. Kill all the ads and the captain here, and the door for the next room will open. In this room, you can also skip the ads, but it's dangerous, so use anything ranged and kill the snipers first. You just have to go from one end to the other of this room and kill the ads along the way. In this platforming area, some ogres will spawn. They will try to push you off the platform. So use something ranged and kill them first, then go safely. Also, don't try to cross the platform if this kind of blight looking objects are there, because this will also try to push you off the platform. Two things you need to know before entering this room. One is that you will not heal in this room. There will be a lot of thralls spawning in here. If you take damage from them, you will not recover. So try to stay away from them. So the second thing is, you cannot double jump in this room. You only have to run, or otherwise you can single jump, but you cannot double jump in this room. Try to put on some mobility mods in your armor and you can quickly and easily get out of this room. Also feel free to use your abilities if you need it. After going straight for a while, you will bend left and from there you will find a staircase. Here you will turn right and go straight and then to the right side. You have to go left from here and then again left. And here you have to jump off the edge. After getting out of this room, you can use your double jump and you can heal again. From here, go straight and then turn right. Here you can go inside or you can come up here and there will be some platforming areas. Now go to the right side from here. There will be some ads. You can kill the ads or you can skip them. In here there will be two doors. You can go through any one of them. Then here inside you have to jump off this edge. Again here will be two doors. And in here, we will start our second encounter. To start the second encounter, you have to jump off this edge. But before starting the second encounter, let's discuss the mechanics of this encounter. An ogre boss will spawn in the middle of this room, and four wizards with some adds will spawn in the four side of this room. The wizards will have void shields, so if you can do some void damage, it will be easier to kill the wizards. Now the mechanic is that the boss will be immune to damage. So to damage the boss, you have to kill the wizards and get a buff from them. Once you kill the first wizard, it will drop a buff, and once you pick up the buff, you will have 45 seconds to kill the next wizard. Once you kill the second wizard before the 45 seconds, you will get another buff. Like this, you have to collect 4 buffs and you have to dunk them in a specific location. Now you can damage the boss after dunking the buff, and if you cannot kill it in the first try, the phase will reset. You have to kill the 4 wizards again, collect the buffs and kill the boss again next turn. So let's try it and see what happens. When the encounter will start, the boss will constantly try to shoot you, so try to stay in the cover and then kill the wizard from the cover if possible. You can see the buff here. Once you or your teammate collect this buff, you will get a 45 second PT Summoner's Mark buff in the left side of your screen. This is the second buff here. Once you have collected it, you will get the Petitioner's Mark buff 2 times. Now you have to kill the third wizard and then the fourth one and get their buffs also. Here you can see the third buff. And so once you collected the third buff, your Petitioner's Mark buff will go up to 3 times. Once you have collected the fourth buff, your Petitioner's Mark buff will change into Petitioner's Burden and you will get a 45 second timer again. In this time period, you have to find the place where you need to dunk them. The place where you need to dunk them is kind of look like this. Any member of your fire team can do this, not everybody has to do this. Once you are done, start damaging the boss. After finishing this encounter, a door will open. You have to go inside that door. If you are doing the Wishender quest, you have to update the quest here in front of the statue. Once you approach it, the quest will be updated. If you don't know how to get the Wishender bow, I made a video on this. The link is in the description below. Now come behind the statue and from here you have to go down. In front of us there is an elevator. It will be guarded by 3 wizards. You can kill them or you can skip them. But after killing them you have to climb this elevator. Make sure to press your jump button before landing from the elevator, otherwise you will take damage. There will be few adds here. You can kill them or you can skip them. After that you have to jump another elevator. Three or four captains will spawn here. It's up to you if you want to kill them or you can skip them. Here again some trolls will come, try to avoid them. Once you are at this area, these objects will try to push you off the platform, so be careful before approaching any further. I will also suggest if there are multiple players in your fire team, try to go one by one. If you die all at once then you will wipe, so let one person go first. If you cross then go others. This is the boss phase. You can see 3 knights there. If you kill them, they will drop a buff on the floor. But this time if you pick up the buff, you will get 45 seconds window to damage the boss. So try not to pick up it immediately. Kill the other 2 and then pick the 3 buffs at the same time. The more buff you have, the more you will be able to damage the boss. You can even one phase it if you have enough buff and enough people in your fire team. If you are unable to kill the boss in one phase, just do the same process again. The knights will respawn, kill them, take their buff and damage the boss again. If you have a hunter on your fire team, then use Tether, the top 3 void, and use Anarchy on all 3 of the knights and they will die easily. Alright, let's take a look at the boss phase. Here you can see the buff. After killing the knight, it will drop a buff like this on the floor. Here I actually make a mistake. I pick up the buff and then I died. If you die, you will lose the buff. And if you don't have any buff on you, you cannot even damage the boss. So be careful about that. Once you pick up the buff, you will get a 45 second timer to damage the boss. That's why you should take all the buffs at the same time. Here you can see after killing the knight there is another buff on the floor. here is the last buff after killing the knight. If you have more buff, you can damage the boss more. Here you can see my screen is turning red. It is because the buff I picked up is about to run out. I have only 7 seconds left on the buff. You have to kill the boss before this timer runs out, otherwise you will die. If you want to do a second phase, there is a fountain like area in the middle of the room. If you stand in that, your buff will replace and you will not die. But unfortunately my teammate has already used the oil, so I cannot use it again and I will die here. So make sure if you are doing a second phase, all of you should go into the fountain almost at the same time. On the second phase, the knights will respawn again. You have to kill the knights again, pick up the buff and then damage the boss. Here my teammate has already killed the knights. Now all you have to do is pick up the buff and finish the boss. Thank you guys, thank you for watching. And if you need all the chest, bones and eggs location of the Shattered Throne, I'll put a link in the description below. Thank you.